Hello, Dirty Girl here with another vintage haul from the flea market. I bought a whole lot of stuff, paid too much for some of it, but I'm going to have some nice stuff to sell, so maybe I'll make up for it in volume, I don't know. But I'm going to start out by showing you the jewelry. I got a lot of jewelry this time. And this first piece is just an absolutely gorgeous. It's a faux damascene Spanish bracelet, which does not appear to have ever been worn. It's completely immaculate. Well, no, there's a little spot on the back, so maybe it has been worn, but not much. It's beautiful. I just love this bracelet. And I bought all this jewelry I'm showing you right now from this lady that she had a lot of different stuff in her space. And there was one box that it had some old compacts in it. So I started looking there. And then there were a lot of closed, you know, boxes like this in that box. And I started opening them up because that's what I do. And then the lady was, well, here's another box that I haven't even put stuff out yet if you want to look through there. She said, just be sure and put everything back in their original boxes. And I was like, oh, sure. And I dug through there and I was finding all this great jewelry. Some of it just looked like, oh, it was beautiful. And then she brought out another box. This is all stuff nobody's picked through yet. So, I paid a bit. I paid a bit for these. I paid $18 for this beautiful bracelet. So, yeah, it wasn't super cheap, but I thought that she was fair. And this is one of my favorite pieces. The last one of these I had sold right away. This is a Victorian reverse carved sterling silver and crystal pendant. It's on a nice chain. I just think that's lovely. And this one, the last one I had, actually had a pretty significant chip in it. This one is in good condition, although it doesn't have the color that the last one had. But I just love that. And I paid, I want to say $15 for that, so not too bad. And this is Danish sterling silver, I think. You know, it's not marked Denmark, and I've got to do some more work on it. But it is it's not sterling silver, it's 830 silver, which seems to be a Scandinavian mark. So if it's not Denmark, it might be Sweden. But It's an older piece. It's got a C-clasp. I think it's early 20th century. It's just lovely. And I paid $12 for that. That was a pretty good price, I think. Let's see. One, two, three. I think I had five pieces of jewelry. And I can't find the fifth one. This is not jewelry, but it's by a jewelry maker, so I'll show it to you. It's a little sterling silver tray. And this is marked by, let's see, Maciel. My cat's throwing a fit right now, so I don't know. She's decided to go on a crazy romp around the whole house. I'm not sure if you can see this, but it's marked Maciel. Some Maciel pieces go for hundreds of dollars. Like, the maker is known for doing really elaborate repoussé trays and things like that. This is a little more plain. It could be an ashtray. I'm not, these little corner, they're not really deep enough to hold a cigarette, so. So, Muffin, you're doing this on purpose, aren't you? Simmer down. Okay. Anyway, I did pay $20 for this. But I'm thinking that's gonna sell for, I don't know, $65, $75 maybe. Oh, now where is the fifth piece? I'm sure that there were five pieces. I don't see it. Oh, dadgummit. So annoying. What did I do with it? All right, well, hopefully it'll turn up while I'm doing this. Bought some pieces from my man Alex. And again, he doesn't always give me the best prices, but usually pretty good. Pretty competitive. So the first two pieces I have to show you are a couple of Zuni inlay men's rings. Sure it focuses so you can see how pretty that is. Now I have been oohing and eyeing over these rings for a number of months, and he always quoted me a price that was just too high for me. And I guess he's tired of looking at them now, so he offered me a price of $30 a piece for these, and I went ahead and bought them. I'm thinking I can sell these for, you know, around $100 a piece. They're quite heavy. They're men's rings, which are always in demand. You don't see as many. And it's just beautiful inlay work with turquoise, coral, onyx, mother of pearl, and abalone. They look like they were made by the same maker, but neither one is marked or signed in any way. They're just lovely. And then I got two more turquoise rings. And these are also nice, big, chunky, beautiful rings. And I paid 20 a piece? 20 a piece for those, I think. Which is, you know, it's okay. And then these rings I paid $10 a piece for these. So this one is a chip turquoise and coral inlay ring, and it's not marked. I don't think any of these are marked. This is a nice Navajo coral ring. Let's see. Nope, that's not marked. This one I know is not marked. This one, I'm not quite sure. I'm pretty sure the stone is turquoise, but I don't know whether it, I don't think it's Native American. It could be, but it's not typical. So I'm not quite sure. And it's completely unmarked. Of course, the fact that it's completely unmarked suggests Native American. But I don't know. But it, I thought it was just beautiful. Really pretty. And that is it for my Alex jewelry. And I have a couple more pieces of jewelry. Well, quite a few, actually. I got this pretty little, this is like an Edwardian style pendant necklace. It's got some art glass beads, very pretty and ornate, a beautiful chain. If you can see this chain, how pretty it is. I don't think it's all that old because it has a barrel clasp, so it's probably 1960s, 50s or 60s. But I just thought it was beautiful. That was $5, and I got this solid copper Native American style piece. I don't know for sure that it's Native. It does have, you know, like arrowheads and whatnot on it. And it's, the only mark on it is just that it says solid copper. This is probably a trading post type piece. It just has that look about it. So, could be Native American, could be not. But it is a nice, chunky, heavy copper bracelet. I paid $5 for that. Okay, let's see. This one, I paid $10 for this. This has a C-clasp. I think it's pretty old. I think it's early 20th century with a faux moonstone. I just love how elaborate it is. That's really fun. I think it's probably silver plated. Yeah, it looks like it's probably silver plated. I haven't tested it. It's not marked in any way. So it might be exciting if it was actually silver, but I don't think it is. But nice piece for $10. That's okay. Now, this next group I'm going to show you, there was some confusion about when I got home and started going over what I paid for this lot of jewelry. I think I got overcharged somehow, or I might have left a piece behind. They might have, when they were, they did the packing, and they may have left one out. I'm sure it was not on purpose or anything, but so it ended up the per piece price for all these ended up being a little more than I wanted to spend, because I don't know, but I pay like $80 for these four pieces, so that's like $20 a piece, which is not terrible, but it's not great either. This is a very large sterling silver and rhinestone piece, probably in 1940s, I would say. It is marked just sterling right there. But I do like it a lot. And it is big, so I guess $20 isn't hideous for it. And then this watch, the little watch pin, and this, I'm going to say, was also $20. It was marked $30. See, originally she was giving me half price on a lot of these things, and so I know that she quoted me half price on this, which would have been $15, and on that silver pin, but then I don't know what happened. Sometimes I don't pay close enough attention, which is not a great thing when you're trying to find bargains. But anyway, this watch, the brand is Rensie, R-E-N-S-I-E. I am not familiar with it, but it does work. It winds, the hands move. I haven't checked whether it keeps good time or not, but it seems to be ticking right along when I wind it. Looks very Art Deco. Oh, it does have a mark. I don't think I saw this mark before. It's gold filled. Looks like it says 1/20th 12K, gold filled. My question is it over sterling? I don't know. But anyway, cute little piece. And then I got another one of these Mexican sterling silver and abalone bracelets. And this one has one tiny piece of abalone missing right there. But after fixing the turtle, I think this will be a piece of cake. The hardest part is cutting the abalone the right shape to fit. But this one should glue in a lot easier than the turtle did. So I'll try my hand at that and let you know how it goes. It is signed. And again, I was supposed to get this for half price, but I think I paid full price for it. It is signed JPA, I think, and I have not looked that up yet. But anyway, it's a nice piece, and I'll do okay on it. And then this last piece, super interesting. I really haven't done any research on it yet. But it is a charm bracelet. Let's see if I can get it. I can see it. Oh, come here. Okay. Here we have it. It's a charm bracelet. Just very interesting. And these dangles are made from various substances. Some, I believe, are seeds and nuts. Some are carved wood. And some are carved bakelite. I think there's maybe three bakelite. Maybe there's about three of each. I just found it absolutely fascinating. I've never seen anything quite like it. And I would have paid $20 for this. And this, I think, was originally priced at $40, so I did get that one for half price. Yeah, there's the original tag for it. It says carved wood, bakelite, and stone seed charms. Stone. I don't know about stone, but anyway. Okay. There's that. And let me see if there's any more jewelry, but I don't think so. I think that's it. But sort of in the same category of jewelry is this darling little sterling silver baby brush. Very, very Art Nouveau. it's a super nice example, and it's in really good condition. It's just Mark Sterling. I don't think it has any other maker marks on it. And that, that was the fifth piece. That's right, I forgot, it wasn't jewelry. So yes, this I paid, I think, 15? 15 for, maybe 20, but I think it was 15. And it's just lovely. And I tried to do some research on this, and I just couldn't find anything that was really this nice. I found other, you know, brush and comb sets for adults, but nothing as beautiful as this. So anyway, I'm hoping that will do well. Okay, now I really am done with the jewelry. Now this, I actually got this at a garage sale, but I only got one thing that day at garage sale, so I'll just fold it into this one. This is a pink, seems like it's Lucite tissue box holder, or it's really hard to find the long tissue boxes that are this narrow anymore. They're all, you know, taller. So, but what you can do is just take the tissues out and put them in here. It's very pink. It's a very 1950s. And this has a little smudge of dirt on it, but I can get that right off. And it's otherwise in great shape. $2. Okay. On to the stranger things that I bought. This is a very dirty brass mold. Not 100% sure what it's used for. I was shopping, ran into my friend Caroline, who was the one that gave me all the door hardware, at the flea market, and we shopped together for a little bit. And she is a chocolate, she claims to be the largest chocolate mold dealer in the world, which probably is true. And there was a chocolate mold that she was looking at the same time I was looking at this, and the dealer was telling her this was a chocolate mold, but she was like, no, that's not a chocolate mold. She thought it, because it's brass, it was meant to go in the oven, and so she thought maybe it was a bread mold of some kind, but I really don't know. But it's got fish, and it's brass, and it's old, and I paid $10 for it. I did find one other one online just like it that was priced at $30. And it looked like it was in better condition, but I got to clean this up. I think when I clean it up a little bit, it'll look nice. I'll shine it just a tiny bit. I know people are like, don't ruin the patina. But, you know, you got to make it look pretty. And this is a little box, which I was told is from Morocco, and it's, that's just a little, it's not really a chip, just a little rough place right there. There's the bottom, you can tell it's old by looking at the bottom, and that, I think I paid $7 for that. And then this, it's going to be a little hard to show you this because it's so big, but I got this giant wooden jewelry box with the inlay. It's quite lovely. And I only paid $15 for it. Price started out at $25. I was like, oh, I don't want anything that big. But the dealer didn't want anything that big either. He didn't want to pack it up and take it home. What's that? That looks like a little bit of candle wax on there, so that should be okay. Inside, it's got all, it's red velvet, and it's got all these cool trays. Tray. Come on, come out of there. Another tray. Another one of these things. And that's it. So, anyway, I haven't been able to make it all fit together yet and still close. So, I may have to play around with the order of these things. This is probably the top one. I don't know. But anyway, 15 I paid for that. There's the bottom of it. These, I just thought these were cool. I got two of these. They are cast iron little candle holders. They're not antique because they're definitely used. They're filthy. But they've got Phillips head screws in the bottom, so that means they're after the 1930s. You know, possibly 1950s, maybe? Because this type of wrought iron was pretty popular then. But they may be much newer than that. I don't really know. But I paid $10 for the pair. And this is one of my favorite finds. I bought a baggie with these two things in it. This is the one I was really going after. It is a porcelain, hand-painted porcelain-handled button hook for shoe buttons. This part, unfortunately, not silver. I think it's just steel. But this is in just beautiful condition. It's not worn at all. And then this one is celluloid, unless it's ivory. Oh my God, it might be ivory, in which case I can't sell it. I think it's ivory. I didn't realize that. I was thinking it was going to be celluloid. I'll have to see if I can figure out for sure what it is. But yeah, if it's ivory, I can't sell it. Maybe I'll just use it. It's a shoehorn plus a button hook. $10 for the two of those. Books. It's a three-volume set of the 19th century and after. It's published in 1906. And it's got a lot of pretty pictures and things in it. Wait a minute, I'll show you one of them. Like that. It was a fairly popular book in its day. The covers are in pretty good condition. Not perfect, but pretty good. And I paid $5 for the set. They don't sell for a whole lot, but they do come with this beautiful ribbon wrapped around them. So they're really nice decorative books. I bought some more doilies. These were a buck a piece. They all need washing, but I'm still working on my lace doily curtain, and I think, I'm struggling with it a little bit, but I think it's going to work out okay, and I think it's going to look really neat when I'm done, I hope, but I may not have enough to finish it, so that's why I bought a few more. This, which is a tea strainer that you put on top of your cup. And it's an advertising piece. It says, if we haven't it, no one has. Just slogan doesn't really roll off your tongue, does it? It is the Jones Drug Phone 1138. And it's on 1420 Main. Unfortunately, there's no city. I'm going to have to see if I can figure out. If I can figure out who, Jones Drug, that's going to be, there's probably a million Jones Drug stores, but maybe I can find the one that was at 1138 Main Street, no, 1420 Main Street. But I love these little advertising pieces. I've sold a few of them before, and they don't sell. I paid $5 for it. They don't sell for a lot, but they're just fun. I don't know. And let's see. Is this the last thing? Oh, I have one more garage sale purchase to show you, and I'll have to bring it over. It's heavy. But this is, I believe this is a spice box. And I think that it is from either India or somewhere close by. And it's got a little lid on a chain, and it smells quite nice. Yeah, I was trying to find one like it online. I could not I just couldn't find anything that was like it. And then I was just looking for this. I know I've seen this style of metal, this like tin overlay over wood. It's like stamped and punched tin that's nailed in. Oof, a little sharp piece sticking up. And not really sure. I paid $15 for that. It's got to be really old. Okay, and then I'm going to take you over to show you the other garage sale purchase, which is to keep, not to sell. So this is what else I bought at the garage sale. There's a couple of, I think they're mahogany TV trays. Got two of them. Oh, there's only one here, but I have two of them. Obviously, they have some scratches, need a little work, but they're sturdy, and we've been wanting some TV trays. These are pretty classy looking. So, paid $3 a piece for these. So, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and subscribe if you haven't, and share and comment, and all that good stuff. And you can find me at vintagedazzle.etsy.com if you're interested in buying any of these pieces. Hopefully I will get these all up fairly quickly. As I said, I have a low inventory right now, so things are going right up. All right, see you soon. Bye.